Remember those 20 discus that we ordered? A variety pack, 3 inches each. Well, they've landed in Dartmouth, Nova Scotia at 1 fish, 2 fish, and we're headed there now to pick them up. We made it. It takes me about an hour to get here from Truro, Nova Scotia. My goal is to only buy, or at least pick up what I've already paid for, which is the discus. But since we're here, might as well look around. A lot has changed.
Looks like all the tanks are lined up over here now.
I always like these. Look at the size of this. I wonder how much it is. 180 bucks. Still not bad.
Oh, damn. Look at the plants. So it's Friday today, and I guess it's Black Friday, but they're doing their Black Friday sales tomorrow.
Jeff got 20 discus, a variety box for himself as well. So I'll be able to see his before I see mine. So we'll get a good idea on their size and that sort of thing. I don't know why I'm looking at everything, because I can't buy anything else. I mean, unless there's something I really need to have.
Ooh, there is a lionfish in here somewhere.
Where is he?
Oh, he's right in front of me. So tiny.
He's half the size, if half the size, of mine. A lot of times if you want lionfish to work, they gotta be the same size.
Here's a comparison of mine right now. He's just too damn big.
It'd be fun to grow him out. He's the same type as one of the ones that I have right now.
He's really small. Lionfish aren't that common around here anymore, but I really need to build that pride. And I've already begun to build the lionfish pride. Look at these big convicts.
I don't think those are purebred convicts.
Are they? I think they're short bodies. They look like they might have some Texas cichlid in them, especially the one up here, am I right?
I'm trying to show you guys some stuff, but I'm gonna be honest, like, I just wanna go see my discus. Look at the size of this Oscar.
It's been a rescue. I'm not feeling that great. Oh, he's got a hole in the head. Good water flow, a better diet, and clean water is gonna clean him up, no problem. Depends on how far he's gone. Ugh, his whole forehead's caved in though, I don't know. Oh, poor guy. Man. Nope. It's not my fault. Not a fish rescue. Okay.
Look at him.
It's just on one side. Look at his eye. Aw, oh, poor fella. I think they'll get him all nice and healthy and somebody will come get him. If you do get him, if you are watching this, and you do come and pick this guy up, let me know how he does. Oh, you know what I want to see?
We haven't seen my rays for a while. Well, they're Jeff's now, but... And my old pair. A female and the male. I kind of want to take that male off him because my female's the same size and just as he's sexually mature. So they do well together.
But I really don't want hybrids. Oh, I got another new Asian arowana.
I wonder what this is. It looks like a red to me. Got a little bit of red on his gills. Can't really expect much out of him at this size.
Let's go find my discus.
How are we doing today?
Here to get some discus.
Down on the end.
All the discus are in here?
Yes, yep.
So they all look pretty good, besides a couple that are just kind of laying down, relaxing, but all right. Taking a closer look at some of these guys, they're pretty much going to all be okay, but some of them don't look in great shape. But when you're getting discus from a wholesaler versus a breeder, you can kind of expect hit or miss in terms of quality and whatnot. I'm not entirely impressed, but I'm still going to get what I already paid for. I'll grab my 20. And I think I'm going to stay on the lookout for more and more, and I'll just keep getting some and kind of trading or selling or until I get my favorite, 12 to 16. Now I just gotta figure out which ones to get. I gotta do it 20 times.
Some of these whites are actually blue.
Back home with the discus. I'll show you what we got, but I need to spend probably the next 30 minutes or so or hour acclimating these to the tank, or at least to the temperature out here. But we'll see what we got. I think that these guys haven't eaten for a week or so. Oh, I guess I'm a newbie, or some Java fern for the discus planted tank. I did pick up some more things while I was there. Sponge for those do-it-yourself filters. A couple of these. I got a project I had in mind. just popped in my head the other day, and I think you guys would like it, like a do-it-yourself filter thing that I want to build. And then just a bunch of fish food. These guys haven't, they look a little bit rough. So that's like a blue and a white one. It's gonna be tough to know what's what, because it's like a variety. No names were like provided or anything. Yeah, so some of them have like sunken bellies and stuff. So, long trip to get here. And then of course, no food for some time. But I do feel like I did get quite a good variety. Downside is there was like a lot of white ones. And when you have small white discus, it's kind of hard to know what they're actually going to look like long term, or what they're going to end up being. I'll know within a couple of months, I guess. I'll be able to figure it out. Some of them are really cool though, really nice. I mean, I feel like they're gonna be okay so long as we can get them to survive the first 48 hours. And that's something that I wanna talk to you about is like, oh, here's another. So some of them are like orange. We'll see how they do. Hopefully they do well, but there's 20 here, and the 20 I picked were essentially the healthiest one with the biggest color varieties. But one of the things that I need you guys to know is these guys got to be quarantined. I am seeing some signs of potential issues. Doesn't mean they have them, but I have to be cautious and quarantine. So that guy just swam in front. He looked like he might have some sort of fungal issue with his fins. And there's like a little orange one in there as well. Some of them have sunken bellies. It could indicate that they are starved, hungry, which is fine. You don't want to gut load fish before you ship them, you know, 24 to 48 hours in flight. But it could also be an indication of parasites, which is common with everywhere. These didn't come from necessarily a discus farm either, more of a wholesaler. So they're not going to be the ultimate best quality, but I'm totally fine with that. I'd rather have fish that you have and that everybody can get and that you'll actually see in your fish store. So a lot of reds and whites and only a little bit of blues in these bags. I really like the white ones though, so I kind of was a little biased and started getting more. Some of them have like yellow faces and whatnot. As you can see, they're in relatively good shape, but I'm going to temperature acclimate them. And during the time that they're being temperature acclimated, I gotta jump on and get a bunch of others. He's kind of floating, this like a orange one. So these kind of looked red or white in the store, but once now they're home, they're kind of looking orange and stuff. Hopefully I don't lose any. I don't know if I showed all the discus. Of course you'll see them here in a future video. Yeah, pretty awesome, eh? I can't remember what you've seen now and what you didn't. You know, I think it's still gonna be pretty cool, and I do have a nice pair of cobalt blue discus to add in a splash of blue. But we have the aquaponics fish. Get them to come over. You can see them. You guys even see that? So a little baby red-tailed catfish. We've kept them before. I specifically kept them just to show you how to build a tank. And to show you just how fast these buggers really grow. And if you must keep them, here's how to build a cheap and affordable aquarium. But I'll be honest, I really miss them. And I've got some friends in the industry that also wanted a couple. So I actually ended up getting three of them. And I'm gonna grow them all out, probably for like 6 months, pick my favorite, and then the other two will go to my friends. So we'll get to have three of them for quite some time, but obviously I can't keep all three. 375 with one of them in there is going to be perfectly fine. But now let me show you the problem that I'm facing that I have to do right now, and why we're not gonna be adding them to the tank in this video. It's quite simple. This is the tank they're going in. The Java fern's going all throughout the center, so hopefully that grows in. Discus are doing fine, but they can't stay in here with these guys. These guys are perfectly healthy, especially these two. I'm gonna move her back with her boyfriend.
But these two have got to go in a tank on their own until the quarantine process is done with this tank. Then the blues are coming back into it because they're not that much bigger. They're only about 4 inches, 4.5 inches, and the small ones that I just got are closer to, they're rated at 3 inches. I should add, why would I have done this in the first place? Why would I add those adult discus to that 180-gallon tank, knowing that everybody's eventually going to go in there? Because that was kind of the plan. I wanted all the discus in that tank. Eventually, once those new 20 went through quarantine, now their quarantine was supposed to take place in the house in a tank that I had set up. That never went according to plan because I decided a few years ago that I would get some Savannah cats, and they decided that I can't have anything nice. With that said, I had to jump on making some temporary changes, and that is removing the adults from the tank, which ended up not being that easy, setting up a temporary tank for them, which is the 40s, because that's all I have left available, and then those 20 discus can go in that bigger tank. I can't quarantine 20 discus in a 40-gallon, but 2 discus can go in a 40-gallon. Anyways, that's how it all worked out, and we got it all fixed up. Back to the video. Oh, and where are they going to go? Well, the blues are coming in here. I already started to set up their tank right before I left. I started building the 700-gallon filter, and it's original filters here. I think I'm going to use this to feed into this, return it through the walls. We'll run through that in another video or something. We got a 40-gallon breeder there, a 40-gallon here that's going to be for the discus. Shell dwellers are down there, so I'll take the blues and I'll put them in there. I'll put the red in the house with its pair. And I think, and then I can, you know, add the discus, add the red tail, get the Java fern attached, do all that stuff, and we'll do that in the very next video. But we got to put these out back to back. And the benefit behind this is, like, instead of you guys wondering how the discus did, how the discus are doing, how the disc, you won't have to wait, you know, a week or two before I film that tank again, or however long I do it. You'll find out in the very next video how they made out for their first 2 days. That's it. I'm just rambling here. I'll see you guys in the next video.